About 50 years ago, a DJ by the name of Cool Herc was the MC for his sister's birthday party, and he discovered if he used two turntables, he'd be able to extend the song's breaks, and that would result in people starting to dance or break into a dance. They would start battling each other, trying to one-up each other on the dance floor. And as time went on, it evolved and eventually became what we know as breakdancing now, which is very popular around the world. So popular, in fact, that it's going to be an Olympic sport for the first time in the 2024 Paris Olympics. And Nike is capitalizing on this historic moment with a brand new shoe made just for breaking. Nike Jam Black and Gum. And the Nike Jam first dropped on July 16th for $120. This colorway specifically, it is a women's exclusive. The Futura Nike Jam is set to release in August, so definitely keep an eye out if you're interested in this shoe. Now, this colorway specifically is paying homage to the microphones and turntables that DJs and MCs use when they're like hosting breakdancing competitions. And first impressions of the shoe. In terms of the silhouette, I don't love it. It's just something that I'm not like too used to. I wear mainly like retros of Jordans and Nikes, but I think it's a pretty nice shape. There's a lot going on just because of the materials that's used, but the shape itself is pretty nice. And the upper of the shoe, the base, it is this tough mesh layer with 3M overlays on the swoosh, as well as this piping on the upper. So pretty cool look there. And then around the toe box area, the synthetic leather as well. And there's like a pattern to the leather overlays. And on the eye stays, a little bit of suede. So quite a bit of going on the upper. It's not like a very clean looking shoe, very much like a shoe that is meant for a specific purpose. And then moving on to the tongue. This tongue is pretty unique. So it's a very thin tongue, but then you also get like padded areas here. It does feel kind of weird when you're like putting your feet in if you're not used to this type of shoe. Now this shoe came with black laces, no extra set of laces. I think black makes sense on the shoe. It's going for like a more sleek, kind of nighttime looking shoe. White laces might have made a pop, but black laces it is, I think it looks good. Now the Nike Jam comes with a rubber cup sole design with a drop-in foam midsole. And you'll see on the sole here, these like raised dots. That is meant for when breakdancers grip their shoe when they're doing like certain moves. I don't know what the official name is called. And the upside down swoosh, that is also for when breakdancers do certain types of moves. The swoosh becomes the right side up. Very thoughtful design there. And the drop-in foam midsole, very, very thick. I'll get the sizing and comfort later, but should give you a bit of a preview of how comfortable this shoe could be. And you get this rubber outsole, the swoosh in the middle with the gum and black design. These colors, in my opinion, just work really well together. And the box of the shoe, about as standard as you can get, just a Nike box. And now moving on to sizing and comfort, I'm a wide and flat footer. With the Nike Jam, obviously I had no idea how to size it, so I just went true to size. Glad to say it fits pretty well. Very snug shoe, it really wraps around your feet. So whether or not you have wide feet, I do recommend just sticking true to size for this shoe. It's a super lightweight shoe because of the materials that's used on the upper, just a lot of weight savings, very well padded around the ankle collar, and that drop-in foam midsole, that feels very nice as well. So low enough to the ground where like if you're a breaker, you probably prefer that. The tongue being that thin is probably my biggest nitpick. If you wear like no-show socks, it might dig into your ankles, but just don't wear no-show socks. But yeah, maybe a thicker tongue would have been nice for casual use. I emphasize, I'm not a breaker. I don't know what works best for breaking. So maybe this thin tongue works really well for breakdancers. But for me, I would have liked a more padded tongue. But overall, very decently comfortable shoe. Now, usually for a shoe, I give it a sole score, but I usually review like retros. So I don't think the metrics for that sole score really translate well to a performance shoe. The shoe is for breakdancing. Maybe like 10 years down the line, this will become a casual retro shoe. Then those metrics might make sense. But right now, probably doesn't make too much sense. A final verdict of the Nike Jam Black and Gum. Colorway I really like. Black sneaker lover. As I'm getting older, love gum bottoms. So I love the colorway. It's also a pretty decently comfortable shoe. I think you don't have to break in these to really enjoy these on feet. Super light, very well padded. And overall, if you don't mind a more like sporty look, if you're not going for a very casual aesthetic, I think this shoe is pretty wearable too, especially the colorway. Yeah, easy to wear, comfortable, nice colorway, nice and clean. If you like the shape overall, can't really ask for much more. I've never breakdanced in my life, but I do really enjoy watching people do it. And I'm excited to watch it for the first time in the Olympics this year. And I think as a brand new silhouette, Nike did a pretty good job on the Nike Jam. They really did. I'm excited to see more colorways of the shoe, and I'm also looking forward to see who actually buys this shoe, like how people are wearing them. I doubt only breakers would get this shoe. I think a lot of people might just wear it for casual use. But yeah, time will tell. So that's it. Thanks for watching. Soul Inclined. Let me know what you think of the Nike Jam Black and Gum. Like, subscribe, comment, all the good stuff. And remember, tomorrow may never come, so wear your shoes.